Let's welcome back to our conversation Michael Rubin of the American Enterprise Institute. Michael, some strong words there regarding the Saudis from the former Florida senator. Do you agree with his assessment?
I absolutely agree with his assessment. The senator is right. We have nothing to gain from sweeping the Saudi involvement under the rug, and there can be no possible reason in sources and methods, the usual reasons for classifying intelligence, why those documents must remain secret.
Why do you believe those 28 pages were classified, Michael?
I think it's out of diplomatic consideration, so as not to embarrass the Saudis. The Saudis have had tremendous influence in a variety of White Houses, both Democrat and Republican, and they lobbied hard to keep those documents a secret, but I don't think we should be listening to them.
Well, mindful of that, and I guess the simple way to describe our relationship with Saudi Arabia would be it's complicated. For years, the House of Saud has tried to set itself up as an American ally, yet a lot of petrodollars going to Islamic jihadists, in essence. So what is the future of the United States relationship with Saudi Arabia?
Well, first of all, make no mistake, we would not have the radical Islamist problems we have across the globe, from Nigeria to Indonesia and every place in between, if it were not for the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia and decades of subsidizing the most radical, intolerant clerics. That's point number one. We ultimately have to recognize that the Saudis may not like it, but the truth will set us free. Our relationship has to move on.
And when you say that relationship moves on, you're not suggesting cutting off diplomatic relations with Saudi Arabia, are you? How do we change the relationship?
No, absolutely we shouldn't be cutting off diplomatic relations with the Saudis. They have partnered with us on and off since 1945, since Franklin Delano Roosevelt met the King Saud on his way back from the Yalta Conference. But that said, there's no reason why we shouldn't have a relationship based on truth, that we shouldn't recognize exactly what they did. You know, if your goal is to save the Saudis the embarrassment of shining the light on their activities pre-9/11, then chances are they're not going to take any measures to avoid conducting the same sort of activities in the future. Don't give them the safety of opacity.
So, with that in mind, if you could make one suggestion to the current administration regarding the relationship with Saudi Arabia, what would it be?
It would be to declassify those documents now, to deal with Saudi Arabia as a partner, but let's not think that they're a panacea. They're as much part of the problem as potentially in the future a solution. The only asterisk I would add there is Saudi Arabia did seem to have a bit of an about face after they realized they couldn't simply sponsor jihadism abroad and not get struck at home. In the years after 9/11, when they started facing Al-Qaida at home, they became much more serious about the threat. Now our major problem isn't just Saudi Arabia, it's Qatar and Turkey as well, and we should shine the same light of transparency on their actions as we do on Saudi Arabia.
Michael Rubin, scholar at the American Enterprise Institute, Skyping in this morning from Washington, D.C. and AEI. The name of his book is Dancing with the Devil, The Perils of Engagement. And to Michael Rubin, we always thank him for his insights and his time and his assessment of what's going on in terms of the ongoing war against Islamofascism and the relationships we have with some of our allies, principally the case of Saudi Arabia. Again, Michael, thanks very much. Now, when we come back, we're going to take a break from the serious stuff, a little reprieve with Comedy Corner. That follows this break on America's Forum.